Hey, what's up? Ezek here, and this with me is the best Apple Watch Series 7 premium copy known as the i7 Pro Max. So, ayun. Unbox muna natin. By the way, quick disclaimer, this video is not sponsored and this was sent to me for review by Smartwatch Manila, so they did not pay me to say something good about this watch and refrain from saying something bad about the watch. In this video, I'll be 100% honest about my opinions and yeah, my opinions about this watch. But anyways, let's first start with design. So sa design guys, now it really looks like an Apple Watch. I mean, technically, it's starting to look like one. However, it's not the typical cheap plastic feels or appearance kasi this watch ay may solid aluminum build na premium tingnan at hawakan. So moving on sa parts naman, we have a knob or crown sa Apple ecosystem terms, which is turnable siya, and we may use this for zooming in or out sa mga applications or interface and switching in between settings or features. So, ayun. Tapos the microphone and power button. Tapos sa left side naman, we have one speaker unlike sa Series 6 na may dalawang speakers. Tapos moving on, sa top and bottom naman is for the placement ng bands. And lastly sa back, we have the health tracking sensor, charging port, and some informations about this watch. So, ayun. And by the way guys, no, this watch pala has a water resistance rating of IP67. So technically, if you're a fan of using your watch under the water or going to swim or having your watch with you when you're taking a bath, then most likely, we may not be able to encounter water issues or problems with this watch. So, ayun. So guys, that's pretty much about the design department and for me, in general, overall, sobrang ganda, sobrang eleganteng tingnan ng Apple Watch na to despite being just a premium copy. Sobrang identical and similar sa authentic one. So, ayun. Anyways, next department. Display. So sa display, we have a 1.75-inch IPS display na may 320 by 385 pixels and for me, in terms of size, it's kinda small. Hindi siya kasing immersive na mga authentic ones kasi yung aspect ratio is not edge to edge or in simple terms, medyo may kalakihan yung bezels. I mean to be honest, no, I can't really complain kasi same lang din naman lahat or same goes to most premium copy Apple Watches and I have never seen or saw an Apple Watch na full edge to edge or full screen display. So sa screen quality naman for me, it's just fine. Though it's just an IPS display. And that means, in simple terms, that screen type translates to a not-so-decent or vivid and punchy display, similar or compared sa mga AMOLED or high-resolution smartwatches and compared sa mismong authentic na Apple Watch, which I think is OLED display. But again, for me, it's fine kasi it serves its purpose and everything's clear naman and visible. But the only problem for me is that being a technical person, medyo visible or mildly visible yung mga pixels. Tapos yung pitch black display na we commonly see sa mga AMOLED or OLED displays ay hindi kayang i-produce na smartwatch. However guys, however, for an average user naman, it will not totally be a problem or deal breaker. Kasi like, it does its job as a smartwatch and bonus lang doon yung mga features which is pag-usapan natin sa performance department. So, next department, performance. So sa performance naman, ay wait, yung specs, wait lang. This smartwatch is powered by an Apple by the FR5082 processor na may 128 MB or megabytes, not gigabytes, of ROM. And in my case guys, no, in my personal experience, sobrang smooth na navigation across the board. And please do remember guys and take note and keep in mind na this smartwatch is the best Apple Watch premium copy out there kasi it tries to copy or replicate the best or current or recently released na Apple Watch, which is the Apple Watch Series 7. So yun guys, moving on, pag-usapan naman natin yung mga features ng smartwatch na ito. So, let's go! So yun guys, let's first start with swiping the smartwatch from the top. And with that function guys, lalabas yung mga built-in applications or games ng mismong watch. And I just wanna point out guys, no, sobrang mesmerizing yung fact na this smartwatch has built-in games. So beneficial to for those people like me na medyo bored kapag nilobot yung phone and walang magawa and introvert at the same time. Next and last game naman is itong parang aircraft. So basically, we just need to hit this aircrafts ba tawag dito? Ito mga airplanes, ewan. Yan, kailang matamaan natin. And dapat hindi tayo matamaan, guys. So pretty simple lang, guys. Pretty straightforward. So thus the games that's built in this watch. So dito guys, ito yung control center. So number one or firstly is yung Bluetooth enabling, or ito yung function or setting to enable or disable Bluetooth connectivity. Tapos next is flashlight. So basically guys, mag-white lang yung screen. So parang ganyan. So yun, next we have is the brightness level. Controlling the brightness from 1 being the lowest and 5 being the highest. Tapos next we have is screen timeout. So basically, kapag 30 seconds yan, it means 30 seconds bago mamatay or bago mag-turn off yung watch. Next we have is ito, and I think this is for the notifications guys, or notification alert. So pwede siyang gawing mute with sounds or vibrate or something like that guys. So next naman guys is ito, itong 4 blocks. So basically, this is called multi-style. So in simple terms, ito yung parang style ng interface ng mga applications sa smartwatch. And panghuli guys no, is the Bluetooth controller. So basically, we can play or pause the music or video, tapos play or move to the next track or go back from the previous track and adjust the volume. So ayun. So in case that's pretty much about the control center. And next naman is swiping from the left. So in simple terms, lalabas yung mga shortcut menu like this one. So ito yung mga ginamit natin earlier. Tapos yung download application guys, which is a QR code for the dedicated app, which is Massware. The date, day, and yung weather data guys. So ayun. And by the way guys, no, in order for us to change the watch face, what we need to do is to long press the watch face itself. So ganito, 6 watch faces guys, and you may download more sa mismong applications na Massware applications. And the good thing about this one is that pag dinouble tap natin itong watch face, magpapalit siya ng color guys. So from green, may white, and red. So that's nice. So in case of first we have is messages. So in this case, it's more of a notifier than something to use to reply back or chat back or even send texts, emails, chats, etc. So next naman is yung dial. So in this case guys, no, we can dial a number and the call will happen through the phone itself, not through the smartwatch. So ayun. Next we have is contacts. So as you can tell guys, no, wala akong contacts kasi I don't use my SIM card naman for texting nor calling. So walang nalabas dyan guys. So ayun. Anyways, next naman is yung call logs. So same with this one guys, no, no call records or no call history kasi I don't do calls nor receive calls from my SIM card or my phone. So next naman we have is speedometer. So in this case, it counts our steps, yung kilometers run or partook, kilocalories burnt, and yung distance we traveled. So ayun. So moving on, we have torch. So na-discuss natin earlier. So basically, mag-white lang siya guys. So ayun. Next naman is breathe or breath. Ang babasa dito. Breathe ata to guys. But anyways, in this case guys, no, this is used for those people na I think hingalin ata and kailangan ng breathing exercise. So basically guys, kapag lumiliit siya, I think that's inhaling or exhaling guys. Tapos kapag nag-move siya forward, I think that's exhale. So ayun. So next naman is sleep monitor. So in this case, it tracks or monitors our sleep or hours slept, hours and minutes slept all throughout the day or night. So ayun. So next naman is weather. So whatever weather data or content or information that's in the phone, lalabas din dito. Which in this case guys, no, my phone is not connected sa smartwatch kasi I'm using it as a camera. So ayun. I'm sorry. But anyways, next naman we have sports. So we have walk, run, ride, climb, treadmill, and record. So in this case, it counts our kilometers partook or yung distance na pinartook natin, tapos yung time, tapos kilocalories burned, and yung BPM natin or beats per minute. So ayun. And lastly, we have is heart rate or BPM counter guys. So try natin. So next naman we have is blood pressure or blood pressure checker or monitor, and it counts or measures our mmHg ko naman yun guys. So based sa Safari guys, it's millimeter of mercury. So yun, moving on, we have Bluetooth music. So na-discuss natin earlier. Next naman we have is calendar. So ayan. Tapos next naman we have is alarm. Ayan. So by the way guys, yung kagandahan nito is that yung alarm type niya is not by vibration, it's by sound or alarm. Like literally guys, yung sound mismo. And the benefit in that one is that mas maganda or mas madaling tayong gisingan compared sa paggamit sa vibration guys. So, ayun, that's nice. So yun, anyways, next naman we have is stopwatch. So play or pause and reset. So next naman we have is find phone or find my phone. So basically guys, no, if our phone's connected to smartwatch and kapag nawawala yung phone natin, we can just stop, start, and the phone will ring kagad guys to notify us kung nasan man yun. So ayun. Next naman we have is temperature guys, which is in Celsius or degrees Celsius. So ayun. So next naman, we have settings. Tapos time settings to adjust the date, time, and time format. Tapos next, we have profiles. So basically, ito yung para magiging notification type. So kung may notification man, kapag ring only, sound lang yon. Kapag vibration, vibration only. Kapag vibration and ring, both yung dalawa. So vibration and ring. Next, we have brightness, which we discussed earlier. Tapos next, we have language. And by the way guys, na-share ko lang, may Filipino pala dito, which in this case, nakalagay is Filipino. It's P. It should be Filipino, but mabuhay ang Pilipinas. Anyways, next naman is yung password. So we can put password in our watch guys. So ayan. Next naman is we have sidebar. So sidebar switch is on. So basically guys, ito yung sidebar. I'll show you. Ito yun guys. Ayan. So next we have is restore factory. So parang reset lang din siya. So ayan. At panghuli, we have the about section, which is the details or informations about this watch. So ayan. So next naman, we have is Bluetooth camera. So parang remote camera siya guys. I mean, remote camera talaga siya. So in simple terms, no, kapag you're taking selfies or group selfies, tapos you're having a hard time clicking the shutter button, in this case, you may just tap the button here guys, and that will shutter or click the camera mismo. So next naman, we have a sedentary reminder. So bulol ako sa our guys, but anyways, in this case, this reminds us to stand up guys. So if you're the type of person na couch potato or lagi nakaupo or nakahiga, this will help you to stand up and remind you to do something productive. So ayun, that's for me guys. So next naman, we have is the calculator. So as you can tell, sobrang kamukha niya yung interface ng mismong iPhone calculator guys. So ayan. Anyways, next naman, we have is language, which we discussed earlier. Tapos next, we have the QR code for the applications mismo or the application mismo ng Apple Watch, which is the must wear application. So next naman, we have brightness, which we discussed earlier. Tapos next, we have Siri. So bagong addition guys, bagong feature ng smartwatch na to. So basically, we can speak through the watch itself kaya siya may built-in microphone guys. Whatever you say is magka-function mismo sa phone. So ayan. So next naman, we have is the about section, which we discussed earlier. And lastly, we have is style. And na-discuss na rin natin earlier. So sa battery naman, this watch has a 220 mAh battery, and in my case, in my personal experience, yung standby time niya or kung gaano katagal malubat yung watch, in my case, umabot naman siya ng mga 2 to 3 days more or less, which is something naman na normal sa isang premium copy and reasonable naman for its price. So, ayun. So guys, if you plan to buy this smartwatch, I'll be placing the link down below, and big thanks and shout out to Smartwatch Manila for sending these products. Products, yes guys, dalawa sinend sa akin, so I'll be making a review of that soon, so abangan natin. But anyways, thank you very much Smartwatch Manila for sending these products to me, so ayun, thank you very much. So guys, if you enjoyed or learned something from this video, don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe in this channel or in this video, so thank you very much. So guys, now I apologize kung medyo I stumble upon speaking or nabubulol ako, and that's because I've been gone in YouTube for about 3 months guys, and yeah, I also apologize for that, so I hope you can forgive me guys. But anyways, ayun lang naman guys, so that's been it, catch you in the next one. Peace.